paint all the pigs.
Hello everyone and welcome back to step 1.2. And in this model you might recognize from how to paint a traitor guardsman model. And then you know pretty much what I have at my disposal. He will be holding a Khorne banner and he will be having a Khorne demon arm for his left arm and then a Cadian last pistol for his right arm. And he will be having his extra ammo and grenade and then a stolen Cadian helmet, which is having a defiled Aquila on the front. He's supposed to have that around his waist somewhere, token as a trophy for killing a human being. I know that in step 1.0 I said that I wanted those to be more of chaos undivided with a bit of undertone of Khorne. This model, however, will be more of a fully fledged Khorne based character. And for that it's very important to start out with Evil Sun Scarlet, as I said in step 1.0, for the main clothing. And as you can see, this guy is a bit different, as I'm using Kadoshan West on him instead of flak armor. So I thought that how could you do that West more appropriately? And then I thought, why not go for Abaddon Black? I think that would be a very suitable black and red. I think they match each other very well. I will be painting Abaddon Black on the West, I will be painting it on the shoes, and I think I will be painting it on the banner as well. I'm not entirely certain how I should do the pole so far, but it could perhaps be golden, it could be brown, but so far I will not paint this pole, so I will get back to that. And then we could go into the whole, how should I paint the skin for this model, because he's supposed to be more Khornate. There's many ways you could do this. Either you can do just painting the arm, looking like he's being possessed by a demon and his arm is the only thing that's changing so far, but he will be a bloodletter in a close future once it's possessed him completely. Or you can paint the entire skin in that type of fashion. And there are many ways to do that, but I think I will be saving that for later steps so far. But what I will do, however, is that I will be using Lead Belcher for the metallics of this model. So now I have a pretty much foundation for this completed Khorne based model, which is Evil Sun Scarlet on the main clothing, black on the banner and on the west, and then Lead Belcher on the metallics, like the weapon and wherever it's suitable. So yeah, at the moment when I'm recording this, I don't have any other models at my disposal, so I'm not entirely certain if there will be a step 1.3, but you will notice that in my model. So either I will say, and see you all in step 2.0. So see you in a second. So yeah, welcome back here to step 3.2, and let's check out what I've done with the model. I'm a bit far behind on this model actually, so we have to hurry up a little bit, so let's go into details. First of all, I'm going to be using Morningfang Brown. And for that I'm going to be painting the staff of this banner, as you can see here. that will serve as a base. I will also be painting it on the last pistol and on the mark up here and on the, yeah, where it's white pretty much on this part. And then I'm gonna be painting dwarf bronze on over here and on the mark, but I think this part, as you can see here, will be left brown to give it a more like a wood feeling. The same as with the pistol will be left in modifying brown only. Then for skin color, I'm using Cadian flesh tone as a base. And then I'm gonna be painting Ogryn flesh on top of that. For the mask, as you can see here, the gas mask, I had some slight issues, what should I paint that in a good color, and I thought I'm gonna be trying bleach bone and see how that works out. So that's the main idea. So Cadian flesh tone on the arms, the chest and on the face, then Ogryn flesh on top of that, and then bleach bone on the gas mask. I have some kind of somewhat idea on how I'm gonna be painting this skin color, but this is just a foundation of how to begin it, so you will see how I will go from here in step 3.2. So see you all in that step, everyone. Hello, a quick disclaimer. When I said that I was gonna be painting Cadian flesh tone as a skin color, I didn't realize how dark it was, because when I painted Cadian flesh tone and used Ogryn flesh on top of that, this is the result I got. It's very dark, almost too dark for my taste, to say so. So my recommendation would be, instead of painting Cadian flesh tone, you could use Elf flesh, which is an old color. And I think the new equivalent to Ogryn flesh is called Reichsland flesh shade. So when you see the previous part, this is just a change which I'm doing in between, so just so you guys know. So see you all in the next step. Hello and welcome back to step 3.2, everyone, and we're nearing us the final stages of this model. And yeah, let's take a look at what I've been doing. I should apologize because I forgot to mention that I used another color in between this episode, and it's called Ball Red. And I've used it here on the skin instead of just Ogryn flesh. It's more obvious here. What I did was I highlighted red on certain areas, and then I repainted with Elf flesh on top of that again. That is another side note. I did not use Cadian flesh tone as I promised. I instead went with another color called Elf flesh. I first started out with Elf flesh. I painted ball red on then pretty much entire arm. I repainted with Elf flesh on certain areas, and then I used Ogryn flesh, which I did promise to paint, on those areas. So it looks pretty much like this. So yeah, and then we can see that I've painted bronze here and here, and then I've left an area here. So yeah, let's moving on to the next steps, and these are, as I said, the final steps. The first thing I'm gonna be using is sunburst yellow, and I'm gonna be painting that on the hair color, as you can see. over here. And I'm gonna be painting the small dots, as you can see here, in that yellow color. Then I'm gonna be dry brushing with Codex Gray on the base, as you can see here. I'm gonna be painting Moot Green. This is the first time actually I'm gonna try this out. Moot Green on the eye lenses, as you can see here. Let's see how that turned out. Then I'm gonna be highlighting with bleach bone on the jacket which he's wearing. And lastly, the last thing which I'm gonna be doing is non-oil. Yeah, as I said in step 3.0 is that I tend to use or recommend you to paint non-oil way too early rather than you actually should. But yeah, now is actually the appropriate time to do it. So now you know what you will be doing for the next step. You will be painting sunburst yellow on the hair color and on the small dots, dry brushing with Codex Gray, Moot Green on the eye lenses, highlight with bleach bone on the jacket, and finish off with non-oil on the entire model. So now you know what you will be doing for the next step. So see you all in that step, everyone. Welcome back to the final step of this model. Today it is the 8th of August 2013 and this marks as the end of this 10th painting guide. It's quite a relief if you ask me, and it will be nice to go out over to other projects. And yeah, let's check out what I've been doing on this model. Here you have the finished banner. I know this is not the best painted flames, but the base of how to use colors are at least good. You start out dark and you work your way down to a lighter color. And I know the darker flames up above here should be more thin and pointy and flowing and such like that, but I'm not the best painter and I never claimed to be. And let's spin this guy around. As you might know, this is a very heavy banner, so I had to apply metallics underneath so it's staying down here on the ground and not falling over. And I think the blood letter arm kind of worked actually. I don't think it would have worked on a Cajun 4X, but it works on a Kadoshan because they are supposed to be bigger than the regular humans, to say so. And I gave him the mark of Khorne since he's very Khornate in following. So yeah, this is the mark of this painting guide. I hope you enjoyed it and I really hope that it's been useful for you. So yeah, thank you very much for watching this video. Don't forget to rate and subscribe my videos. Please give a thumbs up. And also leave comments on things I'm doing good so I will keep on doing them. And leave negative critique on things I'm doing bad so I will either improve or remove the content entirely. Thank you very much for watching this.